Wednesday on WOW's Spirit Week. Do you know what day it is today? If you're saying sports day, yes, it is a sports day today. So, what does that mean? I have a little bit of surprises in store for you for today's Brain Smart Start. And on today's Zoom call, I'll go ahead and let you know what you could be wearing in honor of sports day. But first, let me go ahead and introduce myself. My name is Stephanie. You know me, right? I say it every day so that you guys can remember my name because I love you and it makes me happy when you say my name. But in today's Brain Smart Start, we're going to go ahead and we're going to sing our WOW song. We're going to do some breathing. We're going to do some gentle dancing. Do you guys like that dancing? There's one song I have in mind that I think you're going to like. And then we'll go ahead and do some more exercising. Then we'll go ahead and do our wish well. We'll sing happy birthday if there's any birthday today. We will do our commitment and I'll let you go for the rest of your incredible WOW day here on WOW's virtual classroom. Does that sound good? Yes? Okay, let's go ahead and get started. First things first, our WOW song. Ready? Wilds, cats, listen up, high five a friend and sing along. Wilds, cats, listen up, high five a friend and sing along. We are all in this together. We are WOW, you and me, united and free. We are all in this together. We are WOW, you and me, united and free. We are all in this together. We are WOW, you and me, united and free. We are all in this together. We are WOW. We are WOW. Awesome. Let's go ahead and do our breathing. Ready? And stop. Smile. Take a deep breath. And relax. Perfect. Let's go ahead and do that 2 more times. Stop. Smile. Take a deep breath. And relax. Awesome. Last time. Stop. Smile. Take a deep breath. And relax. Perfect, Wildcats. Speaking of Wildcats, there's another group of Wildcats that I think you guys like. Do you know who they are? There's one named Troy, and one named Gabriella, another one named Sharpay. Do they sound familiar? Do you know those Wildcats? They go to a high school. Yes, High School Musical. So, in honor of sports day, I thought the best thing that we could do to just kick it off is definitely some classic get your head in the game. What do you say? Let's go ahead and watch it. And then there's a special treat at the end. Let's do this.
Hey, welcome to this very special presentation, the High School Musical Dance Along. We spent a lot of time learning these moves, so don't worry if you can't nail them right away.
Totally. As long as you're feeling it, it's all good.
And if it gets too hard, don't worry. Just take a break and make up your own moves.
We're kicking this off with my favorite, Get Your Head in the Game.
You know, when we were first rehearsing for the movie, I was so nervous about the dancing. But then I realized with a little practice, even Zach can do it.
Oh, Ashley's funny. Okay, so who's ready to get this started?
I am! Come on!
This is it. It is time to get out of your seat. That's right. Get up. Get loose. Shake it out.
Shake it out. Shake it out. Shake it out.
And now it's time to get your head in the game. Let's check it out.
Woo!
Okay, so now we're gonna show you some of the moves. Don't worry, we're gonna take it real slow.
Now, if you're inside, it's probably better that you don't use the basketball, which is great because you don't need one to learn this dance.
Everybody ready?
Yeah!
All right, I'm gonna be your coach for this one. So everyone start by pretending you have a basketball in your right hand. And this is how we get started. You're gonna jump out, dribble left, dribble right, catch, bring your feet together, cross the ball over, and bring it back. Now you're gonna do that twice, but the second time you cross over, you're gonna bring your hand up to get your head in the game. All right, so let's do that from the top. You're gonna start with feet out, dribble left, dribble right, catch, cross the ball over, and bring it back. Feet out, left, right, get your head in the game. All right, moving on. For the next part, you're gonna jump out again, and then it goes pass, pass, turn, behind the back, trick shot, your ball's flying up over your head, so you gotta get ready and catch it, and make sure you spread your feet on that, then dribble, dribble. Next, you're gonna step right, left, right, fake a pass, then pass, dribble between your legs, catch, stomp, and bring your right foot forward, ball back over the head. So are you still with me?
Yeah!
Sweet. From there, you're gonna hop forward twice while taking the ball around your back. So that looks like this. Hop, hop, hop. From there, you're gonna do two more dribbles and spin to your right, cross over, feet together, and take your best shot. And I wanna see that swish every single time, okay? So now you guys have the basic steps. Let's try and put it all together half speed. Don't worry if you mess up. Lucas messes up all the time.
What? Yeah, I wasn't even in that scene.
Exactly. Everybody ready?
Woo!
Yeah. All right, here we go. You're gonna jump out, dribble left, dribble right, catch, cross over, and bring it back. You're gonna dribble left, right, get your head in the game. All right, next it's pass, pass, turn, behind the back, catch your ball, dribble twice, then step right, left, fake, and pass. Next, it's between the legs, catch, step out, then shuffle, 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 dribble, dribble, spin, feet cross, feet together, and then shoot. And that should go in every single time, like I said. All right, nice job, everybody.
Woo!
So, now that you've seen the moves, are you ready to try at full speed?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, then hit it, maestro. 5, 6, 7.
All right, that was awesome.
Okay. Did you learn the dance? It was actually easier than I thought it would be. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope maybe you learned a couple new dance moves, and I definitely know that you were singing along to get your head in the game, because I know that you guys love that song. And it felt appropriate for Sports Day. Speaking of Sports Day, I know that we were just up and dancing, but let's go ahead and do our stretches and exercises that we did on Monday. Remember, we're gonna also do them today on Wednesday, and we're also gonna go ahead and do them on Friday. Yes? I know some of you might have worked up a sweat from dancing, so make sure you listen to your body and take it slow. But it is Sports Day, so get ready to sweat. Alrighty, guys, let's go ahead and do these little gentle exercises. And remember, if anything is too hard, you can sit it out. All right, let's do it.
Next, jumping jacks. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Up next, reach and squat. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Up next, Running Man in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Rest time. Up next, the windmill in 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Up next, prayer pushes in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Rest time. Up next, side leg raises in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Up next, side leg raises in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Rest time. Up next, back turns in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Up next, arm circles in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Rest time.
I'm so proud of you guys for working out and just getting up and moving your body during this time. It's so important to do that because most of us are inside our houses and it's so easy to just sit down and want to watch TV and eat junk food. So it's super important that you take a few minutes out of your day to go ahead and do some exercising or moving your body, whatever that looks like. Yeah? I know, Danny C is having some trouble with it, but it's okay. I am too. But it's important that we push ourselves. So at least together in the morning, we can work out a little bit. Yeah? And make sure you're also trying with Mr. Mo. He's been having some amazing exercise videos. So I just hope that you guys are also following along there. Okay, guys, there are no birthdays for today. I did hear it was Yvette's birthday yesterday. Happy birthday, Evie. I love you so much. I hope you had an incredible day. For our Wish Well, we are wishing well this week our incredible WOW staff with this new transition. They also have to make sure they're wearing masks all the time. And it's going to be really different when we go back to WOW because we haven't been there either just as long as you haven't. So when we all go back in, it's going to be different, but we're so happy that we're going to be able to be together. The most important thing is that we wear our masks, which that will leave for our commitment and our Zoom calls. But when it comes to Wish Well, I just wanted to go ahead and wish well our WOW staff. It's also going to be going through changes. And I wanted to take a moment to also wish well all of our incredible Black families and community that we have at WOW. Yes, I know Mr. Lu touched a little bit more on that yesterday, so let's just go ahead and continue on that wish well. Ready? We wish you well. Awesome. Let's go ahead and do what? Our Wishfell song. Let's do it.
My heart to your heart, I wish you well. My elbow to your elbow, I wish you well. My back to your back, I wish you well. My eyes to your eyes, I wish you well. How can we help everyone we know? How can we help each other grow? Sometimes it's hard to know what to do. Wishing them well connects me and you. Wishing them well connects me and you. My heart to your heart, I wish you well. My elbow to your elbow, I wish you well. My back to your back, you well. My eyes to your eyes, I wish you well. How can we help everyone we know? How can we help each other grow? Sometimes it's hard to know what to do. Wishing them well connects me and you. Wishing them well connects me and you.
You make a difference. Let's move and wish your neighbor well.
My knee to your knee, I wish you well. My shoulder to your shoulder, I wish you well. My hip to your hip, I wish you well.
Memorized, right? All right, you guys, for our commitment is to go ahead and engage in WOW's Spirit Week. So it was crazy hair day, pajama day. Today is sports day. Tomorrow is Disney day. It is going to be so much fun. I can't wait. And then on Friday, it is WOW Day, which just means to wear anything and everything green that you have. And to just think of all of the amazing times you've had at the WOW Center and the love that you have for your WOW family. Does that sound good? Can you commit to that? To just being engaging and present in WOW Spirit Week? Yes? Thumbs up if you commit. So for today's Zoom call, it is sports day. So what does that mean? What can you wear for sports day? Well, I know a lot of you guys have some special Olympics uniform. Some of you played in the UAL and have jerseys. And if you don't have any of those, like me, you can go ahead and wear your favorite sports jersey. I'm going to be representing a soccer team. Can you guess which? Here's a hint. It's not the United States. It's the country my husband is from. It starts with a C. Join in on Zoom and see if you figured it out. But yeah, you can go ahead and wear any type of sports jersey that you have or represent any team. I know a lot of you guys have Miami Heat. A lot of you guys have Marlins. So this is the perfect opportunity to go ahead and wear one of those shirts on today's Zoom call at 12:30. I can't wait to see you there. Yes. And remember, we are practicing wearing our Zoom, not our Zoom. We are practicing wearing our masks. I know it's not fun, but it's important that we go ahead and practice, because when WOW opens up, we're going to have to wear them. I know. But it's the only way we can keep each other safe. And we want to do that. Remember, Zoom at 12:30. Today is sports day and tomorrow it is Disney day. So take out those Mickey ears, find your favorite Disney t-shirt, your Goofy, your Pluto, whatever it is that you have, Disney princesses. I know so many of you guys love Frozen. So this is the perfect day to go ahead and wear one of your Disney t-shirts or Mickey ears and hop onto Zoom with that tomorrow. Today is sports day. Don't get them confused. Alrighty, guys. I love you so much. I hope you had an incredible time. I'm Brain Smart Star. I hope you learned some new dance moves from Get Your Head in the Game, which most of you already knew because I've seen your dance moves on our court. But if you didn't, hopefully you learned those and hopefully you broke a sweat in honor of sports day. I love you. Can't wait to see you at 12:30 on Zoom. And if I don't, I will go ahead and see you on Friday. Love you guys. Bye. Good morning, friends. Welcome to CBE with Susie. Today in our class, we're going to be making a terrarium out of a recycled water bottle. So come along and join me and let's get planting.
Smile and learn.
Hello, friends. They told me you don't know what the water cycle is. Is that true? Don't worry, I'll explain it in a jiffy. I know it by heart. I've traveled the water cycle many times. The water cycle is the process during which water circulates around the planet through the seas, the land, and the sky. All this happens thanks to solar energy. There are three stages in the water cycle that I'll explain along my journey: evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. You can't travel with me, but we'll be in touch through this camera, so you'll be able to see the whole process of the water cycle, all right? Hello, do you copy? Right now, I'm in the sea. This is where the journey begins. Do you see the sun in the sky? The sun is in charge of warming the water, changing it into vapor. Vapor goes up in the sky. This process is called evaporation. Evaporation also happens in rivers, dams, and lakes found on Earth, but to a lesser extent. Brr, it's so cold! Owing to lower temperatures, vapor cools once it goes up in the sky, and it turns into tiny droplets of water that form clouds. This process is called condensation. Droplets come together, they become bigger droplets, and fall on the ground because of gravity. This is how rainfall is produced. If it's even colder, snow or sleet are formed during the same process. We call this precipitation. This is the part I like best. Time to fall back on the ground. Whoa! Here we are again on the ground, and the water cycle starts over. What a day! The water cycle is exhausting. Let's go through what we recorded. The water cycle is the route the water follows over the land surface, changing through different states. The first stage, which we have looked at, is evaporation. This is when water changes into vapor, thanks to sun heat. Water vapor goes up to the sky to form clouds, thanks to condensation. When water vapor cools, tiny droplets are formed and they come together for precipitation to happen. That's all about the water cycle. See you around, friends!
Do you want to keep on learning?
Try for free our Smile and Learn platform for a month and enjoy all of our games, videos, and interactive stories. Go for it! Download Smile and Learn on your mobile, tablet, or PC.
So the items that we're going to need to build our terrarium are a plastic bottle. It could be a big 2-liter soda bottle if you like, or it could be a small plastic water bottle. You're going to need a pair of scissors as well because we're going to need to cut that bottle open. You're going to need some soil. I've collected some here, which is mixed with perlite, which should help things grow, but you could just get soil from your garden. And I've also got some sandy soil that I collected, which will be the native soil or the soil that these plants normally would grow in. Also, you're going to need some rocks for the bottom of your water bottle. A terrarium is a self-contained, self-feeding ecosystem. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be creating a habitat where our plant and the oxygen that it generates is what keeps that plant going. So we're also going to be talking about the water cycle, because the water cycle will be self-contained in the bottle. You will have the lid on it, and it will be generating vapor or condensation, which will turn into like clouds, which will then rain some water back down onto the plant. Then that moisture will go through the soil, it will collect at the bottom, and the whole process will start over again, which is very much how our water cycle works on the earth, right? We all know that the plants make oxygen, and that water on our planet is collected somewhere like a lake or a river or the ocean. Then it becomes evaporation and evaporates with the heat and the sun's rays. Then it forms clouds, right? And then it becomes precipitation, or rain or snow. Those are both two forms of precipitation. And then it comes back down to the earth and the whole cycle starts all over again. It will be the same inside of our little bottle. So the reason I chose a small bottle is because my plant is fairly small. As it grows, I will put it in a bigger bottle so it can grow bigger. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to need to remove the label. So I'm going to be taking that label off. And this is where the scissors come in handy, right? Excuse me. So now that the label is off my bottle, I'm going to cut it somewhere in the middle. And you're going to leave a bit of a hinge so that your bottle can open up and you can put all of the things that you need to put in it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make a little dimple here. Just a place to start the cutting. There you go. And I'm going to cut around until I get close to that spot where I started cutting. See how the bottle does that? Didn't do the greatest job on the cutting, but it doesn't matter. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to put our rocks. The earth has what is called bedrock. And bedrock is the rock that is under our soil. And what that does is it works almost as a water filtration system. So the water filters through your rocks. And these are just rocks that I got from my garden. So my goal with this project is that you guys don't have to go out and buy anything. You can just use things from your backyard or your garden. If you want to go out and get a little plant or have someone go out and get you a little plant, that's all right. So I've put some rocks down there, and these are native rocks. So the native rock in South Florida is limestone. That is what our bedrock is made of. And what happens is when precipitation falls, it goes through all the different layers of soil, and then it goes down into the bedrock, and it usually hits the water table, which is the water that is underground, and the rocks filter that water, and then that water will travel out to a water source or a place where water gathers. like a stream, a river, a creek, a lake, or even the ocean. So I've got my little rocks inside of here, and now I'm going to put my sandy soil in. Now, South Florida, we're very lucky. All of our soil is pretty much sandy soil. So I'm going to take my very well-loved shovel, which I love, my little spade here, and I'm going to put some of that sandy soil in here. In our little water bottle. So I've got a layer of my sandy soil. After my layer of sandy soil, I'm going to put in a layer of this growing soil, which is a potting mix. And I pre-moistened it. It comes pretty moist anyway. And with my finger, I'm going to make sure that it's kind of loose. It's not too packed in. Don't pack it in because then the roots will not have a chance to take root and grow. Okay. So this little plant has quite a big root on it. So I'm going to take my scissors and I'm going to make a hole to make room for that root. And then we're going to put that snug as a bug right in there. Now, because I moistened the soil, I'm not going to need to put a lot of water, but I am going to go put a little bit of water in it, and then I'll show you how that water sits down here. Okay, so I've got just a little bit of water. I'm not going to put all of this water in here because we don't want to drown our plant. I'm going to put a little bit, just enough. You're going to see it going through to the bottom. Do that again. So you see it's going to go through all of the soil and then it will collect where the rocks are. And that's going to be the water that keeps cycling. So now I'm going to very carefully put the lid on our terrarium. And now I'm going to take some tape and we're going to seal it up. Now, this is the tape I have in my house. The ideal tape to use for this project would be that thick tape that you use for packing, but this is what I have on hand. And since that's what I'm trying to do with you guys, is things that you might have in your house that you can use for these projects, that's what I'm going to use. And we're going to put the tape all the way around so that it seals it. If you can get some of that other tape, that would be even better. So we're going to seal that as well as we can. You might need a few strips of tape just because I know that tape can stick onto itself and then it's kind of a pain to maneuver. See, I'm sealing that really nice and well. You don't want there to be any gaps because then the water will evaporate faster than it needs to, or it'll leak out and the oxygen will leak out, and then that's not good for your little plant. Clear tape is ideal, by the way, guys, but this will do the trick for showing you how you can do this. And this is a project that you don't necessarily have to do right now. You can wait and maybe do it next week if you like. I'm going to make sure that my lid is on tight. And over the next few days, what we'll start to see is condensation. You see those little drops of water? Our plant will continue to grow. It will stay alive because the water from the bottom will evaporate. It will create like a cloud atmosphere. You're not going to see the cloud, but that just means that all of the moisture will be at the top, as it would be on our planet, a cloud. Then that moisture will start to come right back down again. It will trickle onto the plant, and that will keep watering our little plant, and it will keep it growing. You can choose teeny tiny little plants if you want to see that growth take place. You can even plant a seed in here and see if your seed will grow. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put this little terrarium somewhere nice and sunny where the heat will evaporate the water, and then the water will again go to the top. Then it will precipitate or come down, and then it will continue. The water will, we will go from condensation, evaporation, to condensation, to precipitation, to collection at the bottom. So this is a simple way to understand the water cycle. And the water cycle is very important. Water naturally filters itself as it goes through this process. Every time it does that, the water is cleaner and cleaner and cleaner. And this is an important part of us being able to have things like oxygen. This is why the water supply on our earth, we should take steps to make sure that it is as clean as possible, because that's all the water we've got, guys. It's been recycling for eons since the start of the earth. So we want to make sure that our little plant here has its best chance to grow. So the more plants we plant, the more oxygen we're creating. And that is always good for our planet. I'm going to be including some instructions with our lesson for today and a short video that shows you how to do exactly the same project but using a bigger bottle. And then you guys can review it again and you can watch the model of how it's done again. And then you can maybe do this for yourself in your house. If you've got some little seeds, plant them. Let's see what happens. Take photos, send me your pictures. I would love to see some nice little terrariums. You could do a better job than this one. You could use a jar if you like, if you've got one of those ball jars. Or you could use just a jar that maybe spaghetti sauce came in. You give it a good rinse, make sure that it's washed nice and clean, and follow exactly the same steps that I just followed. You, with a jar, it's a good one because you don't even have to cut the bottle. But if what you've got is a soda bottle in your house, an empty soda bottle or an empty water bottle, you can use that as well. All right, guys, it's been a pleasure showing you guys how to make your own little terrarium. And I will be posting updates on how this little buddy is doing over the next few weeks. I hope you have a great day. And please enjoy your video from the Deering Estate, which is a place that I hope we can visit again as soon as CBE is back up and running after COVID lockdown. Have a good one. Till next time.
Hi, welcome to the Deering Estate. In today's virtual field trip, we're going to be focusing on the water cycle and its role in the ecosystems as we build a terrarium with a native plant inside. Today we're going to be building a terrarium, which is an enclosed ecosystem that supports the life of a plant or an animal. An ecosystem is a biological community wherein living things, like plants or animals, are interacting with their physical environment. Ecosystems around the world may look different, but they all have two things in common. They have biotic things, which are living things like animals and plants, and abiotic features like water, air, soil, and even rocks. Our terrarium is going to be supporting the life of a plant. All plants need the same basic elements to live: water, nutrients in the soil, carbon dioxide produced by living things, radiant energy from the sun, and time and physical space to grow. The first step of building our terrarium is to choose a container in which our plant is going to live. Your container has to be transparent. We've decided to use a 2-liter bottle, but you could also use things like glass jars. The reason it has to be transparent is so that light can pass through, allowing your plant to go through the process of photosynthesis. To make it easier for us to put our supplies inside of our terrarium, we've decided to cut our bottle open, rather than trying to squeeze it all through this little lid at the top. When we cut it open, we leave a little bit attached so it opens and closes, like a treasure chest. Next, we're going to begin by adding in the soil. Now, when most people think of soil, they usually think of dirt, but soil is actually made up of layers. We're going to be building up our soil layers one at a time. The first layer we'll be adding in is the bottommost layer, which is bedrock. In South Florida, our bedrock is called limestone. Limestone is unique because it's very porous, meaning it has a lot of little holes that help water to easily seep through it. In our terrarium, the bedrock, or the limestone, is going to help us by holding all of our extra water, acting sort of like an aquifer. The next layer we'll be adding in is our sand layer. Sand is created through the erosion of rock. In our terrarium, the sand will help to filter the water as it passes down into the rock layer. The next layer we'll be adding in is our dirt layer. The dirt layer is also known as the organic layer because this is the layer of soil in which most organisms live. Some of those organisms, like microscopic decomposers, are going to be living inside the soil we add in today. When they're living in here, they're going to be producing carbon dioxide for our plants to consume. They're also going to be breaking down nutrients into the soil from things like dead leaves that our plant produces. The next layer we'll be adding in is a small layer of mulch. This is not necessary, but if you do have access to it, it could be very helpful to your plant because it's going to provide an extra boost of nutrients, something for those decomposers to start breaking down right away. Next, it's time for us to choose our plant. We've decided to use wild coffee, which is a native plant to South Florida. Its scientific name is Psychotria nervosa. If you want to learn more information about that, check out our ethnobotany virtual field trip. When choosing a plant, it's important to make sure that your plant has all of its root system and it has leaves. This is going to ensure that it's able to survive. As you can see, it has the roots it needs to collect nutrients from the soil as well as water, and it also has the leaves that it needs to collect sunlight for photosynthesis. When we plant our plant inside of our bottle, it's important for us to make sure that the roots are completely covered in the organic layer of our soil. The easiest way to do this is by using your finger to make a little hole in the center of our terrarium, and then place the roots of your plant down into that hole. Be sure to be delicate because these roots are very sensitive. You're going to take your topsoil and simply pull it close around the stem of our plant to support it. The last step is to add water. We're going to be pouring about 5 seconds worth of water. The great thing about adding water to our terrarium is that we only have to do it one time. Once our bottle is closed, the water will be trapped inside. Each day, as the sun heats up our bottle, the water will evaporate from the bottom, where the rocks are holding it, all the way up to the top of our bottle. Here, it will condense, meaning it will form clouds, and once those clouds get too heavy, they're going to precipitate down inside of our bottle. Little drops of rain will fall down into the soil where our plant will collect what it needs, and the excess will go right back down to the bottom where the rocks are. Finally, we're going to be taping our bottle shut. We're going to go around with about 2 rounds of tape just to make sure we have a secure, tight hold. If you are using a glass jar to build your terrarium, you won't have to go through this step. Just make sure that your lid is all the way tightened on. If you're missing the lid of your bottle or of your glass jar, you could use tape or even saran wrap to help close up your seal. We hope you enjoyed today's virtual field trip. If you plan to recreate this at home, be sure to share your photos and videos on Instagram with us at Discover Deering. See you next time.
Guys, welcome to another Wild Virtual Sports and Fitness. I'm yours, one and only, Coach Mo. I'm super excited for you guys to be here again with me today. Today we're going to work on some coordination and cardio exercises. I'm super excited. I hope you guys are excited as well. So let's go ahead and get started. I hope you guys are super excited. I'm super excited as well. Let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we're going to do is go ahead and warm up our legs. Let's go ahead and get our blood flowing and pump those arms. I hope you guys are ready and super excited. right, guys, let's get an arm swinging as well. Pump those arms, let's go. And then we're gonna try, go ahead and lift those knees up. All right, now we're going to the side, all right? So we're gonna take one foot and just take it to the side. Here we go. Then we're gonna add, you're gonna put your arms into it. All right, just point your arms down. Here we go, let's work. Let's get that work. You guys are looking great out there. Let's throw them arms, slide those feet. All right, now walk it out. Back in the middle, here we go. All right, so what we're gonna do now is raise our right arm and bring it down. Left arm and bring it down. Let's go, rotate them. All right, now we're gonna bring both, here we go. Make sure we work those legs, keep them moving. Shouldn't stop. All right, now we're gonna work on that coordination, all right? So what we're gonna do is one of our arms, we're gonna put up, and the other arm we're gonna point like this, all right? Take a second for you to get it perfectly. Let's go. Coach Bo is still struggling. I know you guys are struggling, but you have to push through and persevere. All right, so now we're gonna take our right leg and we're gonna swing it around, all right? Do this 10 times. Actually, as you do that, we're gonna add that arm motion into it with it, okay? Here we go, all balance, here we go. We're doing 10 each. After we do 10 with our right hand, we do what, 10 on the left hand. Let's go. There you go, left side. Guys, it's easier if you focus on one place on the ground to keep your balance. We're gonna always be moving. Let's go, get those feet moving, legs moving. All right, let's go. All right, so what we're gonna do is kind of like butt kicks. All right, we're gonna kick our leg, our foot, as far as we can to our butt. We're gonna go to the other side. We're gonna rotate, all right? So here we go. So now, guys, we're going, here we go, back and forth like this. Here we go. All right, as we go here, we're going to take that arm and we're going here too. Let's go. All right, keep it moving, guys. Feet going. All right, so now I want you to run forward and run back, all right? So you're gonna take one step forward and one step back. Let's go. Ten jumping jacks. Here we go. Right into 10 squats. Ready? Here we go. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here we go. Walk it up. Put the arms in there. Let's go. Get those arms moving. Alright, with this, we're gonna add our jump shot. Let's go. Side to side and pull up. Amazing job. I'm gonna go ahead and give you a couple minutes, get some water, take a second, wipe your face. I know you guys are all parched out there, so go ahead and take a second, and I'll see you when you come back.
Make sure you guys stay hydrated.
This is only temporary, yeah. knees and I pray, ay, ay. Get on my knees and I pray. Get on my knees and I pray, ay, ay. Get on my knees and I pray. Get on my knees and I pray, ay, ay. Get on my knees and I pray. Get on my knees and I pray, ay, ay.
Get right back into it, all right? So first thing we're gonna do is gonna pump those legs. Let's go. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a step back, okay? So we're gonna kick our foot back on our opposite foot here. So it's gonna be a motion like this, all right? Let's go. And make sure you kick that leg behind you. You wanna kick it back as far as you can. Make sure we're breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. All right, walk it out. All right, we're gonna go front and back. All right, walk it out, let's go. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna take a step forward, squat, step back, squat, forwards, squat, backwards, squat. All right, now guys, what we're gonna do, gonna make sure we continue to walk it out. Let's go. We don't want to stop. We don't want to stay stagnant. We're gonna keep moving into our transition. Let's go. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna squat and jump. Squat and jump. Squat and jump. Squat and jump. We're gonna do it 10 times. Let's go. Alright, walk it out. Alright, next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna stand on one foot, and we're gonna take our opposite foot. So you're gonna stand on your left foot, take your right knee and pull it up, and then we're gonna hold it. 10 seconds. Now, if you can't hold it for 10 seconds, you want to try to hold it for 5. If you have trouble doing it for 5 seconds, you want to hold it for 3 seconds, all right? All right, so let's try it again. We're going 10 seconds. Ready? Go. If you fall, don't worry about it. Just get back. Just balance yourself. Get right back into position, lift that leg, and recount. All right, let's do it again. Here we go. All right, we're gonna go ahead, switch it again. Here we go.
Someone who makes me wanna give it. You're the special someone who makes me wanna.
go. Switch legs one more time. Here we go. Switch one more time. Here we go. Last one. Good job, guys. Way to work on that balance. All right, so now give me 10 squats. Here we go. Ready? Go. Alright, now we're gonna go right into bowling, alright? Here we go. We're gonna take a step and bowl. Whoa! So you gotta stay on balance, alright? Take a step, follow through, kick that leg out, come back, same thing. Here we go. So one, two, three. Good job, guys. So now we're gonna do a baseball swing. Here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, eight, nine, 10. Woo. Good job. Hard work right here. So now what we're gonna do is gonna hold our leg, touch our foot, whoa, and come back up, and then go to the opposite. Here we go. We're gonna do each feet 10 times, all right? So you should touch your toe 10 times with each hand. Good job, guys. Now, you're gonna stand in place and you're gonna jump. Short hops, let's go. Let's go. Let's go, let's work. All right, we're gonna keep it going. Then we're gonna do one foot at a time, here we go. So one foot and four front, one behind. Let's go, rotate them. Now we're going out. All right, front and back. Side to side. Run it out. Side to sides. Go ahead and add that arm to it. Here we go. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna pretend we got a basketball in our hand. All right, we're gonna have our basketball. We're gonna pretend that we're gonna touch the floor with it and then bring it up and shoot. All right, we're gonna do that 10 times. Ready? Go. Don't forget to leave this knee up. As you go down, the goal is to not let this leg touch the ground at all. That's the goal. You're all gonna get there one day, but it's gonna take time. All right, it's gonna take time, dedication, and perseverance, and lots of practice. All right, let's start now. Here we go. Basketball in hand. Touch the ground, bring that knee up, shoot it. Same thing. It doesn't matter if you almost fall or not. We're gonna do five of these, all right? Five. Woo. One more. All right, now we're gonna switch feet. Woo. Good job. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna rotate. All right, so we're gonna do like this. And jump, touch the ground, and jump. All right, we're gonna do that 10 times. Ready? Go. And try to hold it. Try to use one foot only. You guys are doing an amazing job. You guys are almost falling just like Coach Mo, but we're still doing it and we're gonna finish all the way to the end. All right, doesn't matter if we mess up or not, we still doing this. Yep, me too. We all together, all right? And we all trying to get better, get stronger, get healthier. All right, so we can all be together. All right, good job. Clap it up for yourselves, guys. You've done an amazing job. Really amazing. I love to see you guys work hard, sweat. All right, so just make sure you stay hydrated, drink plenty of water, wash your hands, stay healthy, work hard. Make sure you listen to your parents or guardians, whoever's taking care of you. Make sure you listen to everything that they tell you, because they're telling you this for a reason, all right? And it's to protect your safety, all right? So I love you guys, and I miss you all. And until next time, peace and love.
Hello guys, hope you guys are doing all well today. Today we're gonna go over a PowerPoint presentation about employability skills and some of the skills that you need in order to be employed, okay? So let me go over to the PowerPoint. During the PowerPoint, as you see in front of you, we're going to have a little activity at the end for you to do. Okay, you're gonna choose two of these skills. These employability skills, you're gonna choose either communication, teamwork, problem solving, initiative, and enterprise, which means initiative, take the initiative to do things, right? Planning and organizing, self-management, learning, and technology. Okay, some of the things that we've been doing now is learning and technology. So let me go over to the next slideshow. So just a couple of seconds here more so you can see the skills, communication, teamwork, problem solving, initiative, planning and organizing, self-managing, so that's time management, learning, and technology. Next, let's go to the next one, okay? What about you, okay? So we're gonna play this video now. I'm gonna play this video now. It's gonna last about 14 minutes, okay? I want you to see through it, and you're gonna see that everybody is capable of doing these skills and having these skills in order to maintain a job, right? And like I said, everybody can do it, right? We're all unique in each other. We all have different skills. We're all strong in some skills, and then other skills we have challenges, right? They're not weaknesses, but they're more like challenges that we have to get better at. Okay, so let me just put on the video so you guys can watch it, and I'll be silent for those 14 minutes so you can just watch it, okay?
While there will always be job-specific skills that an employer is looking for, most employers will also want you to have some general skills. These general job skills are called employability skills. Having employability skills can help you get employment. Generally speaking, there are 8 skills that employers want you to have, no matter what industry you're working in. 1. Communication. 2. Teamwork. 3. Problem solving. 4. Initiative and enterprise. 5. Planning and organizing. 6. Self-management. 7. Learning. 8. Technology. In this video, we'll look at each skill individually to demonstrate practical applications, showing you a variety of elements each skill involves. Communication. Depending on the job, communication is about being a good talker and a good listener and using communication devices. It involves being confident when speaking to people face to face. Some of the key elements of good communication skills are listening and understanding what is being said to you, speaking clearly and directly, or using your device to communicate, reading independently, using numbers, sharing information.
Could you grab me a 5-liter of Pulse, please?
Yes. Here you go, Sue.
Thank you. Chicken parm. Yeah. Chips and salad. Yeah. Table 19.
Hey, Matt. Yeah. Can you wash that camera in the wash bay when you finish here, please, mate?
Sure can.
Thank you.
I got pineapple feta. And I got chalk on top.
Thank you.
Teamwork. Teamwork means being good at working with people, both the people you work with and other people that you come into contact with, like customers and delivery people, etc. Some of the key elements of good teamwork skills are working with people of all ages, being able to listen closely and speak clearly, knowing what your role is in the team.
Ben, can I have a super coat?
Yeah, no, good.
Yep, thanks.
Hey, Daniel, can you please bring in the car because I'm finished with it now?
Yep, no worries, mate.
Thank you.
Right.
I'll hold, you drive. Remember to keep that moving on her. That's it.
Nikki, I finished. Is there anything I can help you with?
Yes, please, Courtney. Can I have 3 pink turbots?
Problem solving. Problem solving is about being able to find solutions when faced with difficulties or setbacks. Even if you can't think of a solution straight away, you need to have a logical process for figuring things out. Some of the key elements of good problem solving skills are: if there is a problem, think hard on how to solve it or ask for help. Think about how you've solved a problem in the past.
Three blue ones, three red ones, and two orange. Blue. Excuse me, Jason.
Yes, Kate.
Is there any red fill tail paint?
It says we've got 20, Cody, so yeah, they should be either in the storeroom or they should be over there where some of the tail paints get stored, all right?
Yeah. Oh. Tail paint. Three tail paints, red. Good, yourself?
Good. I was just wondering if you could help me find the Bonnie working dog there.
Yeah, sure. It's right this way.
Yep. No worries.
Here's the Bonnie working dog, Henry. Would you like?
Oh, I'll just grab the one for now, mate.
Yep.
Initiative and enterprise. Showing initiative can be seeing a problem or something that needs to be done and just getting in and doing it without being asked. It can be not waiting to be told what to do next, but asking, what can I do next? Some of the key elements of good initiative and enterprise skills are: ask what you can do, not waiting to be told what to do, being able to stop doing one task to do something that is urgent, then going back to the other task.
Luke, is there anything I can do for you?
Yeah, mate, you can go and take those bikes out the front.
Yeah,
thanks,
cool.
Tim.
Thanks.
Vicky, can I have my lunch break now, please?
Yep, off you go, mate. No problem.
Thank you.
Is there any plates, Julie?
Yes, my darling. You can take that if you like.
Can I take a plate?
Oh, yes. Thank you. That was delicious.
Excuse me, Courtney. Could you go down and get me some milk, please?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
That would be $60, please.
$60? Yep, sure, here you go.
I'll just lock you out.
Yeah.
And have a good day.
Okay, see ya.
See ya.
Planning and organising. Planning and organising are working out what is required to get a job done and then working out when and how you'll do it. They're also about things like developing project timelines and meeting deadlines. Some of the key elements of good planning and organising skills are coordinating tasks to be done, making lists, having the right tools ready for the job at hand.
Excuse me, Jason. What would you like me to do after lunch?
We've got a few jobs on after lunch, Cody.
Yep.
So there'll be the bins that need emptying. Yeah, we need to stack some steel away.
Yep.
And there's some stickering to do of those poly fittings out there, mate, too. You write them down, that's a good idea. It's a good initiative, mate.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Okay, Nick, we need 3 lengths of timber, 775 long. Okay, now you've got to cut those off on the saw.
Self-management. Self-management is about getting on with your work without someone having to check up on you every 5 minutes. You should also be able to stay on top of your own tasks and make sure they are done on time. Some of the key elements of good self-management skills are being at work on time, wearing the correct clothing, asking to go to lunch, writing to-do lists, watching your time.
Morning, Clayton. Sorry I'm a little bit late.
That's all right. Good morning, Vicky. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good morning, Vicky.
Good morning, Gordon.
Will I start washing the buckets?
Thank you, that'd be great.
Learning. Learning is about wanting to understand new things and being able to pick them up quickly. It's also about being able to take on new tasks and adapt when the way things are done in the workplace change. Some of the key elements of good learning skills are being enthusiastic about learning new skills, being willing to learn on and off the job, being prepared to invest your time in learning new skills.
Because you're going to wash and I'm going to be your assistant, okay?
Yep.
And now just hold it down here low so you can keep control over it and start washing her. Because the soap's already in the bath, as you know. And be careful not to get it, don't come up past her head here, because we don't want to get water in her ears. And don't forget her tail. Got to wash all of her. That's it. And down her legs. Put her back. That's it. And straight onto the table and give her a nice towel dry.
Yeah, sure.
Good
sure,
girl.
Sure.
Good
on real quick and off real quick.
That one?
Yep.
Keep going.
Yep.
Hey!
Thank God, you've done it. I love it.
They're horses. Technology. General technology skills that employers want include things like being able to use a computer, how to use FPOS, a cash register, a photocopier or scanner, a camera or a phone. Some of the key elements of good technology skills are have a basic range of technology skills, being willing to learn new technology skills, be willing to practice using technology.
Underwood, U, N, yep. Now you're looking for G and R, Underwood. That's it. Right, and that brings it down there. Yeah. Okay, so writing in the book, we need to write those figures, so the diesel quantity.
Thank you.
So if you see in the video, there's a lot of different activities or a lot of duties, responsibilities that each individual does. They're all different. One of the girls serves. She also uses the register, right, which is a big responsibility. Some of the other individuals are cleaning. First, they start off not cleaning and being the assistant. Then they become the ones that are doing the jobs because they all learn these skills little by little as you work, right? So you're going to have the skills when you start working, but as you work through and you continue to have a job, these eight skills become better, and some you become better faster than others. Okay, so let's look at the skills. Okay, the skills again were communication. Okay, good communication with your boss, good communication with your employees, good communication with your coworkers, good communication with the most important people, your clients, customers, teamwork, working together as a team, right? Helping each other, problem solving. There's a problem and you can help, you know, and you have, and you know how to do something that the other person doesn't know how to do. You help them and get rid of the problem. Initiative. You see that one of your coworkers is still cleaning instead of you sitting down and waiting or getting on the computer, you are helping that individual continue, right? Next, continue to complete his work. Planning and organizing. Yes, have a calendar, right? So know when you go in and when you go out. If you work at 8 to 12, you work from 8 to 12, not 8 to 12:30 or 1 o'clock and give them free time. No, you want to get paid for the time that you work. So if you work from 8 to 12, you work from 8 to 12. You get there at 8, you sign out at 12, not 12:30. Okay? Self-management, meaning the way you look, the way you're prepared, the way you're ready at work. Okay? Self-managing your day. Making sure you have your lunch, if you're going to take lunch, that you have your STS set up or Uber set up, or your parents are taking you, or your drive, either way, right? Or Metro bus, or whatever it is that we're going to start using now, okay, after the new normal, okay? Learning, being able to say, yes, let me learn, let me try. Technology, which we all learned and is so important right now. The technology is very important. Even if you take the basics again and you start building to harder things, that's good. You don't have to start with PowerPoint. You can start with Word, okay? You don't have to start with Excel. You can start with Word, right? And then little by little, take it up, you know? Word, PowerPoint, and other software that you're going to need to learn, okay? So the activity is for you to pick two skills. So I'm going to give you a couple minutes, okay? Write it down on a sheet of paper. Take a picture of it, right? Technology, we can use that. Communication, teamwork, problem solving, initiative, planning, organizing, self-management, learning, technology. Okay, choose two. And you're going to write examples why you are good at these two, okay? The next time we meet, we'll go over right at the beginning these skills. Hopefully you will bring your paper out that you're writing this on, okay? And you're gonna tell me, I'm probably not gonna be able to hear you, but I want you to go over it while I'm going over my two good skills that I'm good at work, okay? I'm only gonna choose two, okay? Only two, okay? Pick your best ones. All right, guys, that's it for today. I'll see you again on Friday. Have a great day. Bye.
As you all already know, I'm Billy, and today I have a fun day planned out for you guys. Can you tell? Can you guys tell where I'm at? I'm gonna give you time to guess. I mean, you could all already guess. I'm at the track today. We're gonna be outside. I have a lot of activities to show you guys and to do with you guys. So let's get started. And I also have a guest here with me today.
Hi, my name is Fedora.
Her name is Fedora, and today she's gonna be in my video helping me out doing activities together for you guys, okay? For these activities that we are going to do, let me show you guys all the stuff that you guys will need for all the activities, okay? So first you need a soccer ball. This is a volleyball ball. It's very light. And these are the tennis balls, little tennis balls. These are the rackets that we need. And the balloons, you're gonna pack. You can blow them up with your mouth, or if you have an electric balloon blower, you can use that as well. Okay? So that's all you need for the activities that we are going to do today on the track. Another thing for today's activities, make sure you have a water bottle with you. I have me a water bottle. It's the one that you can put ice in it, and the ice can stay, you know, for a long period of time until it melted into the water. It's really good. I got this one from, I believe, Target, and it's really good. It keeps your water cool, fresh, and just how you like your water. You know, when you out there in the sun, you need to keep yourself hydrated. You need some breaks, some water. We are going to take some water breaks in between so we can be hydrated, okay? So let's get water bottles. You can bring any water you would like. And also, don't forget your shades, your glasses. If you like to wear glasses while you out in the sun, you can bring your glasses to the activity, to the track today, okay? So let's go, and I hope you all enjoy it. So it's Spirit Week, woohoo! And I chose to do sports for you guys, okay? And one question, what are you guys' favorite sports? Okay, mine is track and field. I love track and field. I used to run track and field, and it's just my favorite sport. And my favorite player, runner, is Usain Bolt. He's like the greatest athlete to me. He's won 13, 14 championship, and I just think he's great. He's just do whatever he set his mind to do. And he inspired me so much while I was doing track and field. And so what are you guys' favorite sports? Okay. And it doesn't have to be track. It could be soccer. It could be basketball. It could be tennis. Or it could be volleyball. It could be anything. Okay. So what are you guys' favorite sports? And who is your favorite player or runner? Okay, so think about that, write it down, and you guys can let me know the next time we meet.
Okay, so like I was telling you guys about Usain Bolt, my favorite runner of all time. He's a Jamaican runner. He's from Jamaica. He used to run. He doesn't run anymore. And he used to run the 100-meter dash and the 200-meter dash for track and field. So he's my favorite, and I'm going to insert a video for you guys, and you can get a better idea of who he is and how dedicated he is to doing what he set his mind to do, which is to be the best runner of all time.
Before the video, here's a picture of him, and I will also put clips about when he used to run the race, so you can get idea about track and field if you didn't know about track.
We all know Usain Bolt for his absolute supremacy over the 100 and the 200 meters. For close to 10 straight years, he was far and away the most untouchable athlete in track and field, and honestly, he just might have been the most dominant athlete in the world. When you think about Bolt, you think of this. A larger-than-life sprinter with more confidence than pretty much anyone, and although he certainly believed in himself, he wasn't the stone-cold, braggadocious athlete we've seen previously. He was different. He was a relaxed and easygoing runner who would quite often even make jokes directly into the camera. Frequently, we'd see him dancing just moments before his races started. He would even interact with many of the younger workers on the track just moments before he started his races. Man, it's hard not to smile when you see that. I remember watching Bolt during his prime, and I think it's safe to say that he was literally unbeatable when he was at his absolute best. In almost every race, he was so fast that he could easily cruise through the finish line with a huge smile on his face, but he wasn't always considered the greatest sprinter of all time. Throughout his career, we've seen countless world championship titles, multiple Olympic victories, and a ridiculous amount of world record moments. But when did Bolt truly become the greatest sprinter in the history of the sport? What single moment brought him eternal success that solidified him as the undisputed GOAT? This is the story of Usain Bolt's most immortal track and field moment.
And there's the start, and Gatlin did get away well. And Usain Bolt now trying to catch him, and now Bolt surging to the lead, and to the line, he's done it again.
In a lot of ways, Tom, that is his best performance. The time is nothing to write home about.
What's up? So the 100 meters is one straightaway. So it's from here to there. All right, so next up is 200 meters, which is 100 meters of a curve and 100 of a straightaway. So it's from here to over there, and we end at the gate. And for the 400 is one lap, and with the 800 is two laps. And next up is the 1500, which is like a mile, but it's four laps. And there's a 3200, which is eight laps. Then for hurdles, people go over hurdles that are about this high for 110 meters and 300 meters. Alright, so here we are with the sand pit. So this is where we do our long jumps and triple jumps. So long jumps, you try to jump as far as you can.
Yahoo!
And for the triple jump, we do a thing called bounds for three times. So basically, one, two, three, jump it. So also in the jump category, there's also a high jump where you run into a jump and you jump over this bar. So after that is the throwing event. So this is called a shot put. So it's to get a ball, and your goal is to jump in and throw as far as you can. And then for discus, you throw a disc as far as you can. Alright, so last but not least is the relays. So first off, we have the 4x1, which is the 4x100 meter relay. So each person will run 100 meters, and this is a pretend baton, and we'll be running, right? Running. And next person runs. And the first team to complete one full lap with all four members wins the relay. So the last event is a 4x400, which is like a 4x100. But instead of running 100 meters, you're running 400 meters, which is one lap for each person. What's up, Warriors? Thank you for watching this video, and be on the lookout for more videos in the future.
So I know I told you guys about my favorite runner, which is Usain Bolt. He's an all-time favorite runner, championship winner. So to get started, we are going to walk or run. If you want to run, you can run and run the track, but we can walk and do a little jogging, you know, to get your body flowing, to get your body moving, you know, just to get started for your activities. All right, so let's go. You can walk fast, you know, Vivian. Just to get your body started, to get to walking, so you can prepare your body for your activity. It's like a stretch you're doing. So that's why it's good to start like this. So we won't be wake up with our body hurting. Okay? So we're going to walk around the whole track. The whole track. We're going to end the same way we start, the same way we started, okay? You see me walking. Just, even if you feel tired, talk to yourself, put your mind into it, say that you can do it, and you will do it all the way across this track, okay? So let's go, guys. You can do it. Let's go, Fifi. Are you excited for this activity we're going to do? We have a lot coming up, okay? Are you already tired?
You're tired already?
You got this. You can do anything you put your mind into, okay? You know that? Guys are enjoying this walk with me and Fred on today, my guest. It's a beautiful day. It's a sunny day, as you can tell. It's very sunny. You could pick a earlier time to do this, like maybe 9 o'clock in the morning or 10 o'clock. It's better if you do it earlier, you know, so the sun won't be hot and blazing like this. All right, I know you guys got this. We're going to make it to the finish line. Woo-hoo. Come on. If you have a partner to do this with, you have to motivate them, let them know that they can do it. Come on. Do that walk with you. Okay? It's a great day to be out here. It's a fun day, and we are going to have so much fun, and I cannot wait. I feel like running to get my heart rate up. You don't have to run fast, just a little jog. Come on, come on, friend. Let's go. Come on, Fede. Whoa, she's running fast. what she left behind, guys. And I'm back to walk. Activity, we're going to start with the balloon. Ooh, I can't wait to show you guys. So you need a balloon, blow it up, and you might need a partner. Okay, I got my partner with me, and we're going to do this activity. Is the first thing we're going to do is put it in between our legs, and then we are going to walk with it. Okay, walk with it. I will show you guys the line that we will be and to walk with it, and whoever make it to the spot or whoever held the balloon for the longest is a winner. Even though everyone's a winner, okay, in this game, everybody's a winner, and it's just fun to do. It's just something to, you know, just fun activities to do. Ready, set, go. You got this. You gotta go a little bit faster than that. Faster than that. You can't catch me. Woo! I failed. So we are going for a second round. That was so much fun. We are going for another round of this, okay? So the same rules apply. Put the balloons in between your legs, and then we're going to walk with it. Whoever made it to the farthest, or when the balloon falls, that's when the game is over, okay? Alila. Okay. Second round. Second round. Ready, set, go. I got this. Come on, you got this. You got this. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. You got this. We're almost there. Woo! 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 You gotta go faster than that. Woo! I lost once again. Good job, Fyodor. Good job. Woo! Okay, so we're at our second activity, okay? Our second activity, we need a soccer ball, okay? You need a soccer ball. My partner and I, we are going to pass the ball to each other to play soccer. Have you guys played soccer before? I like soccer. I used to play soccer in high school, actually. I used to, I score 2 times in high school when I was in high school, and it was awesome. I love soccer. I love watching soccer. So if you like soccer and you love watching it, you can play with me, okay? Yes, good, I like the way you stop the ball. See guys, just pass the ball. Go ahead.
ball, okay? When the ball's coming to you, you just put your feet on top, you stop it, and then kick it. Stop it, and then you kick it.
Stop it.
Kick it. Good job. Good job. Good job. Okay? Good job. Let's continue. Stop it and kick it. Good job. Stop it and kick it.
Stop it.
Stop it. You see, I can even do it with my left foot. Stop it and you kick.
Stop it.
Oh. So this soccer activity is so much fun. And as you can see, as you can tell, my voice sounds like I'm tired, because this activity requires for you to have a lot of energy or give out a lot of energy, because you're running, you're moving a lot, so it takes a lot of energy for you to do this activity. Okay, I hope you enjoy that. This was so much fun. Okay, so I know we're all tired and we're taking a water break. You guys can do so. Grab your water. You know, stay hydrated. I know it's hot. And let's drink our water. To drink a lot of water, because you know, when you go back out there, so you won't feel, you know, so your stomach won't be too full, because you'll be doing a lot more activities out there, so you don't want to fill your stomach with a lot of water. Okay, just a sip, just to get yourself together, just to, you know, be able to breathe again, and just a little rest time for us to go back out there and do some more activities. Yay! Okay, so for our next activity, I could say it's like volleyball, but it's not really volleyball. And I like volleyball. I like playing volleyball. How many of us like playing volleyball? Do you like playing volleyball?
Yes.
You like it? Okay. She likes playing volleyball. So, it's not in a form of volleyball. I mean, it is in a form of volleyball, but because we don't have a net, so it's hard to do. So I'm going to throw the ball at her, and she's going to throw it back to me. Okay? Let's try it. Throw it and throw it. She's throwing it back to me. Up, throw it up. Woo! Okay, so I'm gonna go farther. You ready? Let's go. So ready, set, 1, 2, 3, go. Oh, you dropped the ball. But still, keep going. Even though you drop it, keep going, okay? Keep going. Woo! And be careful to not get hit with the ball. You like it? You like it, volleyball? You guys like it? Oh, you dropped the ball. Okay, that was it. I hope you guys have so much fun. Okay, so I hope you all having an amazing time out there, just enjoying yourself, playing and doing these activities. Next up, we have, I know you guys can tell, tennis! Woo! Who enjoys playing tennis?
I know I do.
I like watching it, but I don't really play tennis. Or I practice a little bit, but not that I play tennis. But I like it. It's a fun sport to do. It's a good sport to get your heart rate up, to have you sweating and just moving and moving your arms and your body as well, because you have to go in the direction of the ball to be able to throw the ball with the racket. Okay, so let's start. So first, we're going to have the racket like this in order to when the ball comes, when she throws the ball to me, I'm going to use this to throw the ball back. Okay? Let's go. That was fun. Oh, that was low. Ooh. Be careful, guys, to not get hit with the ball. Try to get out the way, okay? I know it's fun. Got it. Another round. We're going to do another round for me. So let's go. Ah, I missed. Ah, I got this one. Ah. Ooh, that was too low. Another one. Oh. 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 You got this. You got this. Oh, good job. One more. Good job. Woo. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching and doing these activities with us. We've enjoyed it. We had a lot of fun today. Thank you so much, and see you guys in the next video.
Hey y'all, welcome back to Spirit Week. Today is sports day, so I'm sporting my Marlins jersey. I didn't get to go to this game. I know some of you got to go to this game where they passed out these cool jerseys, and I still managed to get my hands on one. So I'm happy about that. And I can't wait to get back to a Marlins game because I love baseball. I grew up playing softball, and being a girl from the South, that's my sport. We love it. All right, everybody on your feet. Hello, it's music time. Hello, it's music time. Hello, it's music time, and we're gonna have some fun. Dance around, it's music time. Dance around, it's music time. Dance around, it's music time, and we're gonna have some fun. Clap your hands, it's music time. Clap your hands, it's music time. Clap your hands, it's music time, and we're gonna have some fun. Stomp your feet, it's music time. Stomp your feet, it's music time. Stomp your feet, it's music time, and we're gonna have some fun. Everybody sing with me. Sing with me, it's music time. Sing with me, it's music time. Sing with me, it's music time, and we're gonna have some fun. Thank you for getting onto your feet and dancing and singing with me. So we're gonna do What's That Song Wednesday, Sports Edition, to go with our sports-related theme today. And you guys don't go anywhere after this because my student Jordan from FIU, he's going to be doing his session right after mine. So I'm going to do half What's That Song Wednesday, and tomorrow I'm going to do the other half with that theme, which is Disney. It's your favorite. Make sure you tune in tomorrow with that theme. So we'll do 15 minutes or like half the session today and half the session tomorrow, and Jordan will be right after me each day, so make sure you don't miss that. All right, let's get started. You guys go get your printout or any piece of paper you can write down on, and I will tell you how many points you get for each. So, What's That Song Wednesday? Here we go.
All I do is win, 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 no matter what. And they stay there, and they say yeah, and they say yeah.
We could finish that song. So you guys recognize that song from the WOW experience, right? We used that a couple years back. What is that song called? All I Do Is Win. Yes, All I Do Is Win. And that could be for any sport. I think they play that for a lot of sports. And the person who sings it is Ludacris. Ludacris. There you go. All right. I'm going backwards now. This was supposed to be first. Here we go. Number two.
Get ready. Make everything right. Monday night football coming on tonight. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Do you guys remember this?
All my rowdy friends are back for Monday night time.
All right, so that is called Are You Ready for Some Football? Yes, it is. Are you ready for some football? And what did they play that for? What night of the week did this play? For Monday Night Football. Exactly. Monday Night Football theme song. And the person who sings it? Hank Williams Jr. Hank Williams Jr. So in that case, you can get 3 points. Hank Williams Jr., Are You Ready for Some Football? And extra point, Monday Night Football theme song. And I want to go back to number one. It was All I Do Is Win. And I said Ludacris because Ludacris is on the track, but that's the extra point. The person who does the song is DJ Khaled. That is correct. DJ Khaled. Sorry about that. All right, next. Where have you heard this before? And they bring in a torch. It only happens every few years. That's right, the Olympics. This is the Olympic fanfare and theme. So if you said Olympics or Olympic theme, you got that point. All right, and the same person who wrote many other like movie themes and stuff like this also wrote this song. His name is John Williams. Very good, John Williams. All right, so that one was 2 points. This one, everybody's gonna recognize. It has a weird name though. I did not know the real name. So if you give me the name that I think you're gonna give me, I will take that too. And the extra name will be a bonus point. Here we go. Remember to have fun. Come on, let's clap. Let's sing together. They play this at a lot of sporting events. Said yes, the Hey song. So if you said Hey, you got the answer right. So I thought it was always thought it was called the Hey song, and the official name is called Rock and Roll Part 2, and the person's name who performed the song, Gary Glitter. So in that one, you can get a bonus point. So if you got Hey Song, Rock and Roll Part 2, or and Gary Glitter, 3 points. That was hard. You guys are good. All right, here we go. Next. You know this one for sure. Sing with me. So he said, it's the final countdown. That's right. The final countdown is the name. And the singer, Europe. I did not know that. The train. You guys have all kind of excitement. You have on my days, you have thunder, you got trains. All right, here we go. Next. You all know this one too, and we did it for the show. Mm-hmm. You guys know what it is? Forward a little bit so you can hear. Do you guys get it? All right, so he said the eye of the yes, the eye of the tiger. And the singer, who does this one? Survivor. Survivor. And bonus point, what movie is it from? Yes, Rocky. Good job, guys. Excellent. Here's the next one. We do this one at WOW. And some crazy dance, remember?
Y'all ready for this?
I can see you guys now. All right, so I'm gonna go back one more time and let you hear the beginning because this is the name of it.
Y'all ready for this?
All right, so you said, y'all ready for this? So the name of this song is Get Ready For This. And the group is Two Unlimited. Okay, now, bonus point. You all know this one. What movie is it from? Space Jam. All right. Space Jam. And let me see what number we're on so I can help you guys. All right, this should be number 8. Also, one that you will know. Come on, let's do it.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a
big noise cleaning in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, your big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the. Sing it! There you go. So what did we sing? We will rock you. All right. We Will Rock You is the name. And who sings it? Queen. That is correct. Queen. We love some Queen. All right. Next. Number 9.
Everybody get up. It's time to slam.
All right, so they said, welcome to the Space Jam. There you go, Space Jam. And that is the theme song of the movie, and the group is called Quad City. Quad City. That was number 9. All right, I think you guys know a lot of sports themes because I think you're going to know this one too. This was a really big one. No, no. All right, so you said it a lot of times. What was the name? Waka, Waka. Yeah, that's the name of it. And who's the singer? That's right, Shakira. I knew you guys would know that one. All right. Number 11.
Put your flags up in the sky.
Side to side.
Show the world where you're from.
Where you from? Where you from?
Show the world where you're from.
Different singers, listen. You know that voice. A little bit, because I want you to hear who else is on the track. Here it comes, and who's this? It's me. Who's that? So, a long time ago, they said the name of it, but I wanted you to hear the two singers so you can get them. Who were the singers, first of all? It was Pitbull and J-Lo. Yes, Pitbull and J-Lo. And in the very beginning, they said, put your flags up. Right here, listen. Show the world we are one. That is the name. We are one. Very good. Which is what we need to be right now. One. All right. That was number 11. I am going to skip down a little bit because I have so many songs and I want Mr. Jordan to have some time. All right. Who's this? So what is she saying many times? Wepa. Yes, Wepa. And her name is Gloria Estefan. There you go. Gloria Estefan. You know this one too. I'm made of you. I know you sang that, so you got that point. We Are the Champions by Queen. None other than Queen. Here it is. Now, this is an old classic with two very classic singers.
Him I heard her shout, hey, take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I never get back. Let me root for the home team.
If they don't win, it's a shame.
Cause it's one, two, three strikes, you're out.
So what's the name? Take Me Out to the Ball Game. I know you guys know that one. And this might be a little bit hard. Well, first of all, you can get a bonus point. What sport is that for? Baseball, exactly. And the two singers, Frank Sinatra and Gene Kelly. That is a very cute scene. They're tap dancing and everything. Take Me Out to the Ball Game, Frank Sinatra and Gene Kelly, and baseball. So that was 3 points. Actually, 4, because there's two singers. Come on, 4 points if you got them all. All right, we're almost done. You know, I can't leave out any songs, so let's just hurry. All right, quickly, who's the singer? Shakira, Shakira, Shakira. And the name? La La La. She said La 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 La. All right, so the name is La La La. Easy enough, huh? And that they used for the Brazil World Cup 2014. And WEPA, going back really quick, WEPA, the championship CD in 2012 for the Miami Heat is where that came from. I'm sure it's... Okay, this should be number 16. Here we go. BPM. Look, we on... So say what you say, because that's A with Lecrae. From the A train to the A, I'm coming in. I don't do the most, but I do a lot. I'm going to make a toast, because we still alive. No big... I feel like Pac... Shoot the shot. I'm coming in. All right, he says, shoot that shot. I'm coming in hot. Yeah, I'm coming in hot. Coming in hot's the name. And there's two artists. So you can give your, if you get both of them, you can get 3 points. If you get only one, that's fine. Okay, luck. Cray is the first one, Lecrae, and Andy Mineo. Lecrae and Andy Mineo. This is the very last one, and I included something that's really nostalgic for me because I was in marching band. Here we go. Familiar, it's a super hard name. So I'm going to give you a hint. It's a number. Land of how many dances? 1,000 dances. Land of 1,000 dances is the name of it. And if you said it's a marching band, go ahead and give yourself a point. And there's the person who normally sings it, I will give you a point for that too. His name is Wilson Pickett. It's his song, Wilson Pickett. All right, guys, that's all the time we have. I want you to be able to go and enjoy Jordan's time with you. And until next time, I wish you well. See you tomorrow.
Hello, guys, this is Jordan Lorsius. Welcome back to our new musical therapy session. And today we'll be talking back the same with our same instruments. We're going to continue on our session. We're going to talk about a trumpet, a saxophone, which is like a family of a trumpet. And we're going to talk about a violin. But probably we're going to talk about, first week's National Sports Day. So what we're going to talk about is my favorite sports team. Would love to know your guys' favorite sports team too. My favorite sports team is the San Francisco 49ers. If you guys know, they were in this year's Super Bowl. Obviously, we didn't win, which I was kind of sad about, but the outcome didn't bother me. I was sad about, you know, it's my favorite team, but I was just sad because it was a great outcome. It was a great game. I had some fun watching the game, having fun with my friends, and it was great. Now, National Sports Day, if you guys know, there's a song called Eye of the Tiger. That's just a very popular national sports song. It's played in majority of sports movies. I'm going to play it for you, but first I want to talk about a little bit about sports. So sports has always been an outlet for me, maybe an outlet for some individuals. Growing up, wanting to be the next Michael Jordan, it was just very funny. Like, my name is Jordan, and having the middle name Michael, people thinking I was like Michael Jordan wanted me to pick, I'll be a part of their basketball team. I just fell in love with sports, basketball. Very good at basketball, just never actually decided to join a sports team. Was good at football, offered to got play in an actual football team, but I was very injury prone, so I didn't make it to the squad, but I was a good football player. So we're gonna play Eye of the Tiger. If any sports movie you see, this is a song that's played in a bunch of them. If you ever watched the movie Rocky, then you know. You see, instruments I've been using this song too. Being played. If you tell me what instruments are being played. You hear the drums? The tambourine. The guitar. It's electric guitar. Very loud. The piano. Sing along with you love. This is the guitar that's being played. The electric. Tiger, a very avid Rocky fan. That's one, Rocky 1, 2, 3, and 4. You would hear the song being played. It's a boxing movie. Now we're going to talk about violin, but I'm going to play a song, The Sound of a Violin, so you guys can hear how soothing it is. You hear the sounding tune of the violin. With an instrument. Sounds beautiful. Mm-hmm. $30 based on the player. It's an instrument. It's an instrument that you hold up on your chin. You put the violin right here, and you just stroke it and let it play. Now we're gonna move on to a saxophone. I'm gonna show you what it is, but I'm gonna show you something that. Now, if you guys ever watch SpongeBob, I'm gonna show you the song that they were in the band. All instruments are usually being used: the saxophone, guitar, trumpet. The trumpets. The piano, like we talked about. But the reason majority I played this song was because if you ever watched, if you ever attended a band or went to a football game or basketball game, most instruments like the saxophone, the trumpet, usually sometimes the snare drum, these are what are being played by a band. They all come together and play. If you ever been a part of band rehearsal, these are the instruments that's mostly being played right here. The saxophone, the trumpet. Well, you just have the snare drum. It's usually just like this part, only this part, and the player is only this part right here, and the player has some sticks and they're just playing with the drums. But as you can see, like, music is a family. Everything has a family. All there's wooden instruments, there's string instruments. Music is a family, and these instruments coming together are what makes a band. All of these together. If you realize, this is something that is so important to us. I'm teaching you guys how to identify what instruments are in a song. But as you can see, it's not easy to detect what instruments may be in a song. You have to be very, listen very closely to what is being played. And when you listen to it, you could tell that some instruments, like sometimes some songs may have one instrument that starts off a song, or it may have multiple. And it's your job to detect what instruments being played right then and there. Thank you guys for another great music therapy session. I look forward to talking to you guys some more. Have a nice day.
Hey everyone, it's Isis. So today we're gonna focus on our writing skills, and we're gonna practice writing the letters G, H, I, J, K, and L. Okay guys, are you ready to start? So before we go into writing, we have to do our writing exercises. So this is going to be really quick. So you're going to number your lines 1, 2, 3, and 4. Right? Then you're going to draw a line in the middle, and you're going to number the lines again. 1, 2, 3, 4. So in the first half of the paper, you're going to we're going to practice our circles like this. All the way to the end of the paper. And then you're going to practice the same circles for numbers 2, 3, and 4. But on the half, on the other half of the paper, we're going to practice our lines going up and down like this, top to bottom. All the way to the end. So you're going to do the lines from top to bottom for numbers 2, 3, and 4. So I'm going to give you guys 3 minutes to practice. We're back. So last class with Carlos, we did the first 6 letters, A, B, C, D, E, and F. So the next 6 letters that we're going to do is G, H, I, J, K, and L. So the first letter we're going to start with is lowercase g. So lowercase g, when writing lowercase g, you want to start from one point and you're going to draw a full circle around. You stop back at the same point you started and you're going to do the tail and it curves. So let's practice together. You go around. Stop. And make the tail. Around. Stop. And make the tail. Around. Stop. Make the tail. Around. Stop. Make the tail. So when you're making your G, your lowercase g, you want to make the circle between two lines. So a big circle, stop, and then make the tail. Down and curve. One more time. Around, stop, make the curve. All right. So now you guys are going to practice on your own for 2 minutes. Go ahead. So the next letter we're going to do is lowercase h. So when writing lowercase h, you want to start from top to bottom, and then you go around, basically a half a circle. Top to bottom, and then around. So let's try together. Top to bottom and around. Top to bottom and around. Remember to stay in between two lines. Top to bottom and around. Top to bottom and around. Top to bottom
and around. And always keep in mind that we always write from left to right. So top to bottom and around. Alright, so take 2 minutes and give it a try. So the next letter we're going to practice is the letter I, lowercase I. Lowercase I is very easy. All you have to do is draw a line from top to bottom and circle in a dot. Top to bottom and circle in a dot. So let's practice together. Remember to always use right in between the two lines. So, top to bottom, the dot is okay. So top to bottom, and a dot. Top to bottom, and a dot. Top to bottom, and the dot. Top to bottom, and the dot. Top to bottom, and the dot. We're always writing from left to right. See how easy it is? and always, always, always take your time. There is no rush. All right, so give it a try on your own for 2 minutes. Next letter we're going to you to write is the letter J, lowercase j. Lowercase j is very easy, just like lowercase I. Lowercase j is basically a dot at the top and top to bottom and curve. Dot at the top, top to bottom and curve. So let's practice together. Always stay in between the two lines. So dot at the top, top to bottom, and curve. Dot at the top to bottom, and curve. Dot, top to bottom, and curve. Dot at the top, top to bottom, and curve. Dot at the top to bottom, and curve. Dot at the top to bottom, and curve. Dot at the top to bottom, and curve. 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 Very important to practice your handwriting with a pencil, because you can make mistakes. So if you make a mistake, you simply erase it and do it over. All right, so give writing the letter J a try on your own. Now we're going to do the letter K, lowercase k. Lowercase k is different from capital K. With lowercase k, the back has to be taller than these two lines. So you're going to start from top to bottom, and then out upwards and out downwards. Top to bottom, then up outwards, and down outwards. Let's try together. So for the lowercase k, I would suggest to use just for practicing, three lines for the back. So you're gonna go top to bottom, then come to the middle and go outwards, up, and downwards, top to bottom, upwards, 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 and downwards. Top to bottom, upwards, and downwards. All right. So give it a try on your own. To our last letter for today, lowercase l. So lowercase l is very easy. You're just going to draw a line from top to bottom. That's it. So let's practice together. Top to bottom. So for l, you stay in between two lines. Top to bottom. Top to bottom. Top to bottom, top to bottom, top to bottom. All right, so let's give it a try on your own.
And that's all for today's class. Don't forget to continue practicing some more on your own. Bye.
Bet you're wondering, why in the heck are you wearing that on your face? Well, my friends, it is sports day. I just wiped off some of this, so now it looks even dumber than it did before. But whatever, let's go for it. So, as you know, it is sports day, and you have joined the rec therapy session for today. I'm Luke, and the reason I'm dressed like this is because, well, since it's sports day, I wanted to remind you that, one, you should wear sunscreen when you go outside, if you, well, you should in general, right? And also, these, if you didn't know, I know one of them's crooked and looks stupid, but just assume that it's real, right? These are actually used so that the sun doesn't reflect into the people's eyes. That's why in football they usually put the black lines there, because when you have these there, the sun doesn't bounce off of the skin, reflection of your skin, and it actually just absorbs it, so that way you have better vision when you're playing, right? So, yeah, that's why you do that. But anyway, guys, I hope that you're doing well, and I want you guys to check out this really cool video on a couple sports that you may have not known existed. Check it out.
Adam Hisner.
Big time push for five.
Dynamite! A little Cotton McKnight for you there.
Spin it in.
Fantastic. Under the leg and over the shoulder, same time. Beautiful. Double through the leg. Beautiful over the shoulder. Boom. Double shoulder roll. Fantastic. Nailed it perfect.
Nice. Yeah. Whoa, he told us he was going to pull one out. Maxwell, that was beautiful.
Judges are in conference right now. Here they come.
A 20. 20. 20.
The bet from Carr getting after the muffin tin.
This is one of the most aggressive sudden death overtimes we've ever seen here on the Super Robot Fighting League.
Sudden death, one of the scariest.
There it is. Oh, my gosh.
And you can't have the best of the Ocho without the sport that inspired it, dodgeball. And the Continental Cup between the USA and Canada from Hamilton, Ontario, and a game that needed overtime.
Or they got to hold him for 50 seconds because they got the numbers.
Oh, and he caught it! Jordan caught it! Look at O'Brien! O'Brien can't believe it!
O'Brien crossed Jordan!
USA
caught it! Avoiding the sweep on the day, a big win for the men.
This one is for the whole enchilada. They're locked up, are the competitors. Schmeisner locked up the arm of Horton. It's an unbelievable comeback for Noah Schmeisner.
My off-season training this year has been much more intense than normal years. I've been getting out, I think, the last 3 days. I think I've spit about 4 or 5 pits each day already. I'm ready to go.
Here we go. There it is. Looks like it's a pretty good roll there.
Damn, right off.
Oh,
the
excellent
camera.
Roll. Hey. The Bulldog wins it with 58 feet, 3 1/4 inches.
Pressburg and Dragshot. Here comes the attack from the left side on Dragshot. Club goes down.
That was another between the leg shot. And that's the shot that did it through the leg. Up in and down.
Yeah.
All up in his junk.
Oh,
it was just, I played against that guy so many times, and if you play against him, you know, it's like playing against a mix of Jesus, Gandalf, and kind of a bearded warrior, you know, so you gotta take it slow, and then in the end, you just, he's the butcher, but you got butcher him.
We've got a race to the top, but maybe not for long. Cooper grabs Shane, and the pack goes down. Left at the top is Trent. Trent's all, oh no, no, he's not. He's going down. Oh, we have a clean slate. Can they maintain their balance? Trent is really gaining on Cooper. This is going to be a photo finish as they go to the top.
So guys, welcome back. I hope that you enjoyed that video. I know that it was really cool to see and very interesting to see, you know, all of those different sports that we may have never heard about before. So yeah, that was really cool. And I hope that maybe you could have seen something that you literally have never seen in your entire life and that could have fascinated you beyond belief, right? Because I know that there were some of those on that list that definitely are unheard of, right? My favorite one is actually the stair climbing one. That one was really cool, and I think it would be really fun to do, although it might hurt a little bit. So that's something to consider. So, but I think that that might have been my actual favorite one. I keep on touching my nose. Okay, so as my nose is getting less and less covered with sunscreen, but let's see how it ends up at the end of the video. So, you know, you may be asking, well, I'm home and I don't have access to a gym and I don't have any sports equipment in my house. What do I do, right? Because I want to play something, I want to be active, but I can't because I don't have anything. Well, friend, I will tell you what you can do. So there's actually a list of sports that you can play without any ball or equipment of any sort, right? Five things that you can do without having equipment. Number one, swimming. Swimming, technically, you do need something, and that's pool or any form of water where it's, you know, you can be submerged in it, and that's, it's big enough that you can be submerged in it and swim in it, which would be a pool, right? Or the ocean. But as of right now, a pool probably seems more likely that you would swim in, right? Because of everything being closed and whatnot. Although that'll change soon, but anyway, it's probably safer just use your own pool if you have your own pool. But I think that you might be able to access certain public pools soon. But again, that's safety and precaution. You could also do body weight training. Okay, so body weight training is basically just any form of training that uses your body weight. Plain and simple. So when you want to work out but you don't have any... you don't, sorry, my nose looks really funny. You don't have any equipment and you don't have any weights or dumbbells or anything like that in your house. Well, what you could do is simply use your own body weight. What does that mean? Well, if you have ever done push-ups before, you can tell anyone that they're pretty tough, right? If you're not used to doing them all the time, or if you're not that strong yet, you know, doing push-ups is kind of hard. Well, the reason it's hard is because you're actually working something out. And what do you use when you do push-ups? Do you have to use a dumbbell? Do you have to, you know, call a friend to help you with a certain position for a certain workout routine? No. You just get on the floor and you do them, right? You know, again, if you can't, if you're not strong enough, or if you need help, that's different, obviously. But for the most part, you don't really need anything, right? So that's an example of a bodyweight exercise. It's something that you can do without having to have any equipment near you, okay? You could also do just plain old running, right? You can run around your neighborhood or your backyard, or a park somewhere, right? As long as you have someone with you, that seems like a perfectly safe thing to do. If you, for whatever reason, can't run, well, maybe you could just go outside and enjoy the fresh air. And if you're in a wheelchair, maybe like push yourself with your arms so like you get a little strength in your arms. And if you can't do that, well, just take, honestly, just taking a breeze, walk through the park, if you go to the park or whatever, will be very healthy for you nonetheless. So even if you're not running or being super active, the fact that you're outdoors and not just sitting at home doing nothing is exercise. Maybe not for any muscles, but for this and this, right? You know, believe it or not, your heart definitely benefits from just being outside and being in the outdoors and being happy, right? So that's something that you could do if you are in need of ideas. So some of you, you know, maybe have done this at the Wild Center before, but you could do boxing, right? So a lot of you have hit the punching bag, right, in Mo's classroom, and you guys love it, and you get all hyped with it, right? Well, you don't only have to do it at WOW, right? If you have a big pillow, and you can, like, just set it up somewhere where it won't fall over, you could practice on that thing forever, and no one will ever tell you anything because it's a pillow, and, you know, if it's your pillow, even better, because that means that you can do it for as long as you want, and no one will tell you anything. But that's a really good idea because, well, you can get your blood pumping, right? You can build muscle, right? You can increase your stamina, right? Stamina is just that thing that keeps you going, right? When you want to keep running but you can't, it's because you're running out of stamina. But if you have higher stamina, it means you can keep going with certain things that are like physical activity. So you can increase your stamina actually by boxing. And the way you do that is if you continue to go and go and go, not at the same time and in the same day. I mean, like, you do this over and over again throughout, you know, a few weeks or whatever, you will increase your stamina and you'll be able to do that for a lot longer than you did before. So that is a great technique for getting in shape. If you don't have anything and you really can't buy anything, I feel like that's a good way to go. Just saying. And the last exercise I wanted to show you that you could do at home without any equipment necessarily, although you will need a backpack, which I'm sure 99% of you have. I'll be right back. Okay. So, I'm sure that you guys have seen this before. I know a lot of you pay really good attention to certain things, and so maybe you've seen this bag, but this is the bag I use at WOW. But what I did right now is I filled it with some clothes, and I made it heavier, right? You can fill it with whatever you want, but you know, I chose clothes because clothes are lighter to put in, but when you put a ton of them in, it makes it pretty heavy, right? So what you can do is when you're at home, you get a book bag or any bag, honestly, you put some stuff in it that'll make it heavier, and then you can just use it as a device to curl, right? This isn't that heavy, but if you wanted to put a lot of stuff in it and make it really heavy, you could do that. And, you know, you could build some bicep muscles pretty easily with a 2-minute setup, right? And you don't even have to buy anything for that, right? Because you just use whatever you have in your house. And you just put it in a bag, and you can do that. And you can do other exercises too, right? You don't have to just do curls, but you could do these as well, right? The extensions. You do this because it's heavy, so you can do it with any position. As long as you can hold it in a certain position, you can do whatever you want with this, right? So I actually moved not too long ago, so I don't have certain things that I used to have. But in my old house, I had a pull-up bar. And the pull-up bar is something that you buy where it's kind of just like a bar like that and has like these little rods that come out. And you put it on your door and it kind of holds onto it from the other side. So when you pull on it, you won't ever fall, right? As long as the actual door frame is sturdy, right? Because otherwise, you know, it would fall. But if it's sturdy, then that is actually a really cool way to work out because Well, you can build your arm muscle a lot like that. And you can do other exercises too. You can do core exercises. You can even do leg raises when you're doing the actual pull-ups, right? And so it's like a full body thing almost. But that is actually something you would need to buy, because I don't know of anything that you could just throw up on top of your door frame and start doing pull-ups without it breaking or you falling and hurting yourself. So for that, I would suggest that you buy a pull-up bar.
So I basically wiped off this entire thing. I'm just gonna take it off. All right, that is better. I did that because, like I said, it was already coming off, so I was like, why not, right? I'm just gonna take the whole thing off because now I look stupid. Just kidding. But anyway, I digress. That just means I continue.
So in terms of the pull-up bar, here is a really cool video on how to use it. If you do buy it, I suggest that you watch this video so that you can actually know some things before just going into it, right? Because it's always good to do your research before you do anything, okay? So anyway, here's a video on how to use the pull-up bar.
Hi, and welcome back. This is Andre from Our Nutritionist. Today we are looking at this piece of equipment. So I'd like to share with you my opinion and review this item. I had this for a couple of years and I think it's one of the really nicest pieces of equipment I ever got. It's very simple and very easy to use, and you can pretty much work out your whole upper body with this equipment. So let's have a look at this. First thing we're gonna use this for is to do some pull-ups. So the way this is designed is actually for it to actually fit in your doors. So as you see, this gets right here and then it holds to this side. So you can put it here, got a nice way to just do some easy pull-ups. Now you can do that with your legs up as well if you want to train two things at once. And that's it, you could change the arm position in here to go a little bit closer. Easy as well. And then you could obviously do the other way of the grip in here, right? So you go here. So for some of you, if you can't do the full pull-up, that's fine. What you can do is, you grab it here, you slightly bit jump up, and then you go slowly down. This is a way of sort of passively building your muscle mass towards being able to get yourself up. So another thing this can be used for is push-ups. Now you could do various positions of your hands in here. So first you can do push-ups on here, which is quite nice and easy, which actually gets more your chest and triceps in here, right? Now you could also go for the wider, which will again get your chest quite a bit more. So you go down here. Now you could also go for the middle one, which is here. And if you're really sort of brave, you could turn your hands around and just go this way. It's a bit awkward, but still it counts as a push-up. So another thing that you can use this for is for your dips, to train your triceps, to train your, you know, lats and upper back. So let's get to this. So you face it that way. Now, one thing to be careful over is if you grab it only on one side, you might damage your wrist, okay? So avoid sort of grabbing it here and then damaging your wrist. So what we're gonna do in here is get your wrist on that in the middle, push your pelvis forward, and just do nice dips in here. It's not as easy as it looks because it quite frankly isolates your triceps. So if you can't do it properly, that's fine. Lift your pelvis up, get your core engaged, and then move in the middle in here, yeah, with your knees bent. So it's an easier version. Now then, of course, there are three positions. One is here, another one is here in the middle. So you can go for this, right? And then you could obviously go for the wider one is here in here as well. So that's gonna be that. Now, when we get to training apps on this, there is one thing that I know of that you can do. I'm sure some people might know more things, but as far as I understand, you could get in here in the middle and just hold, which means that you engage your abs quite well. Your shoulders and triceps are working quite a bit as well, which is great. Right, so I hope you enjoy this. Some of the exercises might be a little bit harder, some of them a little bit easier. I hope you got the best out of this, and I shall see you next week.
All right, party people. I hope that you learned something today and that you are staying active in your different houses and wherever you stay, right? But that you're staying active and that you're playing a sport, right? Try to play a sport today. Even if you don't like sports, do something very simple. Technically, you don't have to be super fit and active to participate in a sport, because there are many sports that are actually not too much activity going on, right? Like any board game, technically. Chess is a sport, checkers is a sport. You know, different things that don't require you to get up and start running around and getting super sweaty, those are also sports too. So if you really can't or don't want to participate in like a sport that makes you active, maybe try looking up some things that are sports but aren't too crazy active for you. Some sports that don't require you to move a ton but are still actually sports and you probably heard about on TV before are golf, bowling, cheerleading, fencing, dodgeball, pool or billiards, right? Trampolining, the list goes on. But I promise you, there are things that you can do if you just look hard enough and try hard enough, okay? So don't give up, all right? And don't forget to stay hydrated, okay? Because this is very important. If you forget to hydrate yourself, you're gonna feel really tired and you're not gonna wanna work out at all, right? Because when you get to a certain point, you just wanna stop and you don't wanna do anything because of how tired you are. But the more water you have, the better you will feel, I promise. I don't know if you've ever seen the commercial for Dos Equis, which is just a type of beer, but their slogan is "Stay thirsty, my friends." But I say, don't stay thirsty, because that's not good. If you're running, you're not gonna feel good in a little bit. Stay hydrated. All right, guys, so that concludes our lesson for today for sports day, okay? Again, I hope that you are staying active, that you are participating in a sport of some sort. Esports is technically a thing, right? So again, if you really can't go outside, if it's raining or whatever, you just don't want to, technically esports is a thing. So esports are just anything that involves electronics that happen to be sports. So I know certain video games are sports, different things like that. But you don't have to be outside running around and getting sweaty, although I do recommend that you do that every once in a while, at least. So guys, I love you all, right? And I really hope that you enjoy the rest of your Spirit Week and the rest of what your different staff has planned for you, okay? So I will see you guys in the next video. Take care, guys, and keep on being active. Hello guys, Carlos here, technology teacher. Today I have the privilege to be with you and share with you week number 3 of special topics, which is community integration. But first, if we want to talk about community, we have to understand what is a community. I have a definition here for you, so you can read it or hear it with me. Community is a group of people living in the same place or having a particular characteristic in common. So example of communities are the family, neighborhoods, workplaces, churches, and among others. Now that we know what community is, let's jump to the questions. And I have question number 1. Am I part of the community? I'll give you 1 minute to think about it, and we'll keep discussing. Am I part of my community? Well, there is different ways we can get involved with our communities. Being part of a community is a powerful experience. Communities give us home, friendship, warmth, and a sense of belonging. But how can we really be part of our local community, guys? There is many ways to do it. You can get to know your neighbors, or give your time to others, or just get active in different activities to maximize your own involvement within your community. I know we're not going to the WOW Center right now, but when the WOW is open, we have a special class named CBE, or Community-Based Education, which is the class that takes us out in the community and give us the opportunity to get more involved within our own community by knowing new places or new people, or just get a new experience, maybe in a place that we didn't know that exists. And what are your CBE teachers? Do you remember their names? Okay, let's see. We have Susie and Stephanie, and that's CBE 2. And CBE 1, it's Teresa and Stephanie. Yes, we have two teachers named Stephanie. Don't forget that, guys. Okay, ready for question number 2? Let's go. Okay, question number 2. Are you happy with how much involvement do you have in your community? Once again, 1 minute to think about it. How much we are involved in our community depends on us. If we are able to go out and do, you don't need to do big things. Small things also count, like getting out the garbage, or cleaning your front yard, or helping some neighbors in loading their shopping. Small things also are good things. Now, can you think about other things you can do to gain more involvement in your community? Question number 3. Am I an active and contributing member of my community? Think about it. 60 seconds. You can contribute in your community in many ways, such as volunteering, internships, when you go to work or church or action club for those who are in it. At the end, no matter how you get involved, the important thing is to get involved, to participate, to contribute, and be an active member of your local community. So now I know we're going through a special situation. Now, if we are in a quarantine time right now, and we cannot leave our houses for security, of course, maybe your question is, how can I be part of the community if I don't have any relationship with many people at this time? That's a good question. Well, maybe you do not leave your home, you don't see your neighbors, or maybe you're not going to your work. And definitely, we are not attending to the WOW Center since it's closed. But we can still be part of the community. Doing what? Well, respecting the law. The quarantine was enforced for our security, so you, your family, and your neighbors can keep healthy. And little by little, we can get rid of this illness which is going around the world right now. So now, how can we be part of the community in this moment? Well, staying at your house, respecting the quarantine, and also listen to your families and to your caregivers. Being part of the community also involves to keep the community safe. And respecting the quarantine is how we do it right now. Guys, it was amazing to be with you. I hope you enjoyed this and have a great day. Bye.